Our next caller is Justine from BC, Canada.
Hi, Justine. How can we help you?
Hey. So my question is about MAPS aesthetics. I'm on phase three and I absolutely love it. A little bit of history. I have spent thousands of dollars on personal trainers, weight classes, apps, different programs, you name it. I've probably done it. And nothing has worked for me like aesthetics has. So my question. Yeah.
Sorry.
That was so great.
Yeah. Love it much. Would I be able to do it, say, I don't know, as an example, if I want to do it for like 3 years, would I be able to do it continuously, just one right after another, and see results if I maybe just increased my weights every time I started the program again?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. And number one, the reason why it works so well is because it's programmed
properly. Because Adam's on the cover of it.
Yeah, that's why. Because Adam's body is on
it. That must be it.
No, I appreciate that positive feedback. We designed every single MAPS program to theoretically be run essentially indefinitely, right? They're all phased. You could definitely run through MAPS aesthetic over and over again, going through the different phases. However, if we're speaking in ideal terms, ideally, you'd be better off going through the different MAPS programs, okay? Because, you know, MAPS aesthetic is very bodybuilder focused. It would be great to go through MAPS strong, which is more functional strength, or MAPS performance, which is more athletic minded. All the programs complement each other. And so you'll get overall better results if you go from program to program. That being said, you definitely could continue to run MAPS aesthetic back to back to back, and you should still see some good progress.
We literally just talked on a, I don't know if I talked off air, was off air when we talked, or it was after we hung up with the person, and I was mentioning how I ran MAPS aesthetic for actually most of the time I was competing. So leading up to it, I used programming similar to like how anabolic is laid out. Getting into shows, once I started competing, MAPS aesthetic was really the foundation. Now, I manipulated it, right? So, and there's nothing wrong with you exchanging some of the movements in there, or changing an exercise, follow the form. I mean, the real brilliance behind the programming is how it's laid out, how it's phased, that's really what's so powerful about it. And we build the volume builders into the program. So, but there's nothing wrong with you going like, oh, you know what? I haven't done a Z press ever. Mm-hmm. And this fit time of going around, I'm going to pull out the, barbell press there, and I'm going to do a Z press there. Or, you can take exercises and exchange them, and you'll get a lot of benefit by doing a different exercise, but laid out in the programming very similar. So if it's shoulders, you're doing a shoulder workout. If it's chest, you're doing a chest exercise, but change them up. And then you also have the way we set up the focus sessions. So you'll notice that the focus sessions really only take you about 20 or 30 minutes probably to complete. Well, as I would get ready for each show, after every show, I would actually add more volume into the focus session. Since it was an area that I was trying to work on and I wanted to bring those muscles up, every time I ran the program again, I would add a couple sets to whatever muscles that I'm trying to develop on those focus days. So, and I eventually got to a place where it was 5 days a week. I was lifting an hour every day. So it was, but I worked that in over time of every time I ran it over. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, I think too, we have our main three programs. Like we have anabolic, performance, and aesthetic. And the reason why we're kind of taking people through those is because it has very specific attributes and adaptations that we're trying to teach the body through that process. And this is a long-term strategy. And so there's nothing wrong with finding one of the programs that really resonate with you, and you get great results from it, with repeating that quite frequently. But also keeping in mind some of these other attributes like that you're going to get in terms of like fortifying your joints and doing movements that are outside of your comfort that actually translate really well to then adding more abilities going back into the program that you love so much. So there's a lot of carryover between those main three, and then obviously you can get more intense with some of the other ones that we have. But those, we always kind of try to steer people in that direction because it's a really good long-term strategy.
And there's a way that you can do what Justin's saying too, and still, so I MAPS aesthetic, obviously I'm biased right to that programming because it's kind of how I like to train. So I do go back to that program more than anything else. And so what I'll do, to Justin's point, because there is tremendous value in you moving away from that training for a little while, is I'll actually take a month or one or two phases out of strong and I'll run it, and then I'll move back to aesthetic. Or then I'll take one or two phases out of performance and run it, and then go back to aesthetic. So you doing that has a lot of value too. So if you really love one of the programs more than the other, I always recommend like going through the other one so you see what's in them. And there's a lot of value in you just kind of moving out of that modality and training a little bit different, because it, like Justin said, there's going to be a lot of carryover from the other ways of training for that program too.
Yeah, that makes sense.
All right. Cool. Thank you for calling.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.
No problem. Mm. Yeah, you know, if you are following a MAPS program and you love it, there's nothing wrong with repeating it. But really, when you go through the other ones, and like Justin said, the long-term strategy, you'll just get better results. You'll have more balance. You'll have less injury. You'll feel better because you're training through different styles and modalities.
Well, and the truth is, we say this on the show a lot. It's been a while since we've said it, but you know, I love to say that the best thing that you're doing, you should do, is what you're not doing, right? So the best thing you can do for your body, whatever your goal is probably what you're not doing. You know, if you've been doing something for a very long time, or you've repeated that program, even though they're designed that you could do that, there's tremendous value in going away from that completely and then returning back to that. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times we're all in this room guilty of this. We all kind of gravitate to our favorite,
we go back to the old thing that you love so much.
Yeah,
right?
We do. And I know damn well that it's not ideal for me. I like doing it. And so there's this balance, right? Because you also should enjoy your training. So, I mean, that's part of it too. Like, you want to be able to go to the gym. You don't want to do something that you hate just because it's novel. You know, it's like that's not a good idea either if you're not going to be consistent. But you also have to be self-aware enough to go like, okay, I always do these exercises.
But is this good for me?
Yeah, I always do these exercises. I always train this way because I like it. You know, it feels good because I'm good at it. But you know what? Going over here and doing those stupid matrix lunges, or adding the Z press in there, or doing these movements that I'm not very good at, the truth is, gains will come on fast for that because you're not good at it.
Completely.